Although green, most of Alaska's interior is an Arctic desert, normally receiving less than 12 inches of precipitation a year. During the summer, the precipitation in the interior between June and August is on average between 3 and 6 inches. Because of widespread expanses of permafrost, most of the precipitation that's received is not absorbed into the soil. 20 to 24 hours of daylight provide extensive drying and heating and create flatter temperature and relative humidity curves. On the longest days, there is very little relative humidity and temperature recovery. As a result, the burning period can be from about 0600 to 2300, depending on how far north you are. Statewide, there are 143 remote automated weather stations, or RAWs, that collect and transmit weather data hourly. Typically, interior summertime temperatures are between 70 and 80 degrees Fahrenheit, with an occasional 90-degree period, RH typically 30 to 60%, occasionally 15 to 30%. Thunderstorm activity occurs any time from mid-May to mid-August, with the most activity during June and July. Between Canada and Alaska, there are 21 lightning detectors that provide real-time lightning strike data to a map on the Alaska Interagency Coordination Center, or AICC, website. Each morning in the statewide weather briefing, there is a discussion of previous day's lightning strikes and outlook for the current day's lightning potential. However, the real-time lightning information is closely monitored in near real-time by fire management personnel to determine where new fires may be starting and where detection flights should occur. An upper-level ridge weather pattern brings the most lightning ignitions to Alaska. It usually starts with an upper-level ridge over Canada that pushes into Alaska and lasts for several days, drying fuels. As the ridge weakens, unstable air moves in along the edges, bringing dry thunderstorms to the periphery of the ridge. Though little or no thunderstorm activity occurs directly under the ridge, as the ridge retreats into Canada, the advancing thunderstorms bring dry lightning to those areas that had been sheltered under the ridge axis. Therefore, breakdown and subsequent ridge movement is a significant critical fire weather pattern across much of the state. It is beneficial to know what the upper-level flow looks like for this pattern. 500 millibars is the level we use to determine the main steering flow. Southerly flow aloft is another significant fire weather pattern for the interior. High pressure builds in from the south, bringing moisture to coastal areas and creating strong drying winds, or Chinook winds, along the north sides of the Chugach Mountains, Copper River Basin, the Alaska Range, White Mountains, and Brooks Range. Winds can be funneled and become very strong through mountain passes near Healy and Delta Junction. Any fire activity or new ignitions will have rapid development due to winds and high fuels. Thus, this is another critical fire weather pattern. Again, knowing the upper level flow is key in identifying this pattern. Northerly winds will bring very dry air despite cold temperatures. This pattern sets up with the high pressure over western Alaska and low pressure over Canada, or with everything rotated clockwise, high over northern Alaska and the low over the Gulf of Alaska. Either setup may lead to strong northerly winds, clear skies, low humidity, and cool temperatures. These strong north winds will funnel and accelerate through mountain passes, increasing fire danger in many areas. It is therefore a critical Alaska fire weather pattern. The upper-level flow pattern for this critical regime has two possible adaptations. Backdoor precipitation is important for the way in which it can subtly bring large amounts of precipitation into the eastern part of the state. It begins with a low-pressure center near Yakutat, which begins to move northward, often repositioning in the Copper River Basin. This brings moist, southeast flow from the Gulf of Alaska, and thus rain into Copper River Basin and the upper Tanana and even upper Yukon valleys. The difficulty is predicting how much moisture will make it over the Alaska Range. The backdoor precipitation regime is therefore a season-slowing event. The 500 millibar flow reflects the well-stacked low in the Gulf. Southwest flow is the wettest pattern for most of Alaska and can signal the end of the fire season. When a flat ridge of high pressure builds into the Gulf of Alaska, the upper-level flow parallels the Alaska Range. This allows clouds and rain to reach into the usually protected areas of the interior near the Alaskan-Canadian border. If this pattern sets up for several days, It will bring enough moisture to extinguish most fires. One note, the Copper River Basin may still be protected by the Talkeetna Mountains. This pattern may be a season-ending event, particularly when it occurs in August and lasts for several days. This upper-level pattern may or may not be a welcome event.